Hello team, welcome to my YouTube channel and my name is Prat Nair, and if you want to know more about me, you can refer my LinkedIn profile. If you're new to this YouTube channel, do subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon. So make sure you should not miss any update. Today we're going to discuss about biometrics. This topic is more specific to the people who are preparing for CISM, CSIN, CISSP. I receive a lot of feedback. Hey Prat, we always get confused on FAR, FRR, CER and all that. So I thought I will make one short video which explain about this process. See, when you're talking about authentication, okay. Authentication is a process of verifying the user who claimed to be. Example like when you type username and password. Okay, username is a process of identification and the password is the verifying the person who claimed to be. Or you can go to airport to say my name is Prab and I'm traveling from Trivandrum to Delhi. So they ask you, okay, we can see your name in the list. Could you please confirm your passport? Or could you please confirm your Aadhaar card? Something you have which can say you are Prab. They're actually doing an authentication. So when we're talking about the authentication, we have three factors of authentication. Something you know, which is a password. Something you have, like token or smart card. And something you are, which is biometric. Biometric. But when we're talking about biometric, the biometric is basically has two way to verify your identity. One is basically physiological based on your physique and does this authentication, and second is based on your behavior. So first is basically physio, how's your physique, and based on that they verify. Example like fingerprint, retina, iris scan, palm scan. Okay, so these are basically your physio base. And second, behavior base, how you behave. Example like voice base, signature base and keypad. Signature base, what we have seen in your Pearson View exams. You have to sign your documents on a digipad, so they compare that signature with the database, the document that you attested or provide, because you need to carry one ID proof with the signature in the case of CISSP exam. So biometric have a two way to verify your identity. One is called physio base or second is behavior base. But concern here is in biometric is all about how they basically perform the authentication. Okay, so when you're talking about in a behavior base, in the biometric, how the process works. Suppose this is your scanner. When you place your finger on the scanner, it captures your image. It captures the image of fingerprint and stored in a form of template. So next time when you place your finger, they capture the template and compare with the stored template. This process is also called one-to-many identification. One-to-many identification. So they compare your image, what you have placed, your scanner on the scanner and all that, and then compare against the stored database of a template. So this is called as a one-to-many or one-to-one identification. If it is match, then it give access. But problem is that biometric, it doesn't offer the 100% accuracy. It never offer 100% accuracy. That is why in the biometric, we have two type of error. One is called as a FAR, and second is called as a FR. FAR stand for false acceptance rate. False acceptance rate. And FRR is called as a false rejection rate. Now, what is false acceptance rate and false rejection rate? When we're talking about false acceptance rate, it means the machine has accepted a false user as an authorized user. Okay, example like someone tried to mimic my voice and does authentication. He's not authorized for the system, but he mimicked my voice and gain access. Why? Because machine failed to identify if it's accurate or not. That is called as a false acceptance rate. Or someone has basically placed his fingers on the machine, which is similar to my fingers and all that, and does the authentication. It means falsely accepted by the machine. That is called as a false acceptance rate. But false rejection rate means where the authorized user, he is an authorized user for the system, but it is falsely rejected by the machine. Sometimes what happens is when you're riding a bike and all that, you're coming back to the office, even your information, your data is stored in the biometric, but when you place first time, machine reject your access. Even you're an authorized person, but still machine reject your access. That is called as a false rejection rate. Now I will tell you why this happened. So false acceptance, where unauthorized user accepted by the machine as an authorized user, and false rejection rate where authorized user rejected by the machine. That is called as a false rejection. Now in the CISSP exam, they don't ask you based on FAR, FRR. They ask you based on an error rate. So how to remember? If you want to walk 1 mile or 2 miles, definitely which one is far? 2 mile. So 2 is far. So that is why the type 1 error is FAR. And opposite is, type 1 is basically, 2. Because 2 miles is basically far. And FRR is opposite, which is called as a type 1. So this is how you can remember. Because if you want to walk for miles, so 2 miles is basically far than 1 mile. So FAR is called as a type 2 and FRR is called as a type 1. Okay. Now question is, how they basically accept or reject? So when we're talking about a biometric device, now it's a most important part of this section. Now we have one section which is called as a sensitivity. And second is called as a error rate. Now, if you increase the sensitivity, it means you're increasing the sensitivity. It means if the machine has a higher sensitivity, what is the meaning of that? The meaning is it take more time. It take more time to verify the information. It captures more and more information. Until unless they don't find the conclusive evidence, they will not give the access. So if the sensitivity high, it captures more information, it look for more accuracy and then give access. That is why when sensitivity high, in that case, FRR will be high. Even the authorized or unauthorized user both get rejected. But if you decrease the sensitivity, like this way, then in that case, FAR will be high. Because now what happened, if the sensitivity low, because we're talking about sensitivity low. Okay, in that case what happened is, based on the basic information only, they give the access. So this is basically called as a FAR and this is called as a FRR. So best optimum point where the biometric should tune is called as a CER, crossover error rate. This is the best optimum point of biometric to work, which balance your FAR and FRR. And try your best to keep this value as low as possible. So by this way, what happens, you can able to control the FRR also. And you can able to control the FAR also. But if you go above the CER, then in that case, FAR is also high and FNR is also very high. That is why when we go for the biometric system to be configured in the organization as per the CISSP, we ready to accept FNR over FAR. Because I am okay even the unauthorized will get rejected. I am okay even the authorized will get rejected. But I am not okay that unauthorized user falsely accepted by the machine. That is why whenever we install biometric in a very critical, very sensitive area, my preference is FRR should be higher than FAR. Okay? So that is the point we have. So we always keep as low as possible the CR value. So by this way, we can able to establish the more accuracy in the biometric system. Another important thing, post-COVID, there will be exam question, post-COVID, which type of biometric will be least accepted by the organization, like hand geometry and the fingerprint sensors, okay? If the question talking about most accurate with acceptance, then iris scan is the best because it capture your, the area portion of the eyes and based on that give access. Retina is not accepted, but it is the most accurate. You know why? Because it scan the blood vessel of eyes. So exam point is iris scan is more accurate with the acceptance. Okay. So whenever we plan biometric device in the organization, first we need to review the privacy policies. As a security consultant, you need to review the privacy policy. You need to review the international legal regulatory requirement, because when you're dealing with the privacy, you're somehow dealing with the PHI or PII data of the user. Their consent, their acceptance is the most important thing before implementing a biometric in your organization. So if you find this video useful, do share in your network. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon to receive the new updates. Thank you.